Here in the I button and description box below, we'll get complete playlist of partial fractions. Okay. Basically, in the playlist, you will find three videos, and three videos means three types. Okay. Yes. In this video, we're going to solve first type of problem based on partial fraction. Okay. Before I start this video, I would request you to, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, then please subscribe it. Okay. And if you learn something from my videos, then please hit the like button and do share the playlist of this chapter with your friends. Okay. Yes. I need your support, so please support me. Okay, let us start. Type 1, that is in which the denominator contains non-repeated linear factors, or you can say in which the denominator contains distinct linear factors. Okay, in this we are going to solve five different problems. Okay, yes, these are five examples of this type 1 in which you will find denominator as non-repeated linear factors. Okay, and I will be solving all the five questions, in which fifth question is a bit different. Okay, yes, and I'm 100% sure that after solving these five problems, you will be able to solve any problem that belongs to this type one. Okay, so let us start with the first example, that is 1 upon x square plus 5x plus 6. Okay, 1 upon x square plus 5x plus 6. So first we need to solve this. Okay, that is x square plus 5x plus 6. We can divide this 5x into 2x plus 3x. Okay, so if you take x plus 3 common, okay, so x into x plus 3 plus 2, if you take 2 here common, that is 2 into x plus 3. So you can write this as x plus 3 into x plus 2. Okay, now this can be written as 1 upon x square plus 5x can be written as 1 upon x plus 3 into x plus 2. Okay, now this can be written as a upon x plus 2 plus b upon x plus 3. Okay, yes, here we have x plus 3, b upon x plus 3. Here we have x plus 2, a upon x plus 2. One thing is very important, that order is not mandatory. Okay, order is not important. You can write b upon x plus 3 plus b, sorry, a upon x plus 3 plus b upon x plus 2. Okay, yes, you will get the same answer. The end result will be same. Okay, yes, now take the LCM, that is x plus 2 into x plus 3. A will be multiplied with this and b will be multiplied with this positive sign. Okay, okay. Now if you compare this with this, you can cancel the denominator part, you will get 1 equals to a into x plus 3 plus b into x plus 2. Okay, now we want a and b, the values of a and b. Okay, to find a, this term must be 0. Okay, this term must be 0. To make this term as 0, we need to put x equals to minus 2. Okay, so put x equals to minus 2. Yes, since 1 is a constant value, so 1 will be as it is, a into minus 2 plus 3, that is 1. Solve this, you will get a equals to how much? 1. Okay, now we want the value of b, so this term must be 0. Okay, this term must be 0. To make this term as 0, we need to put x equals to how much? Minus 3. Okay, so put x equals to minus 3. This one will be as it is because it's a constant value. This term vanishes because x equals to minus 3, plus 3 will get cancelled. Here b into minus 3 plus 2, minus 3 plus 2, that is minus 1. Okay, solve this, you will get b equals to how much? Minus 1. So put equals to 1 and b equals to minus 1 here. Okay, you will get your answer. Okay, yes. So finally we can say, that is 1 upon x square plus 5x, okay, plus 6 equals to a, that is 1 upon x plus 2 plus b, that is minus 1 upon x plus 3. Okay, yes, minus plus will become minus. So 1 upon x plus 2 minus 1 upon x plus 3 is the final answer for this example. Okay, now coming to the second example, very important. Second example, that is 1 upon x into x plus 1. Okay, again we can write a upon x plus b upon x plus 1. You can write a upon x plus 1 plus b upon x. Order is not that important. Okay, yes. So if you take the LCM, that is x into x plus 1, a into x plus 1 plus b into x. Okay, yes. Now if you compare this with this, denominator part will get cancelled, so we will be left with 1 equals to a into x plus 1 plus b into x. Okay, yes. Now if you want to find the value of x, a, if you want to find the value of a, put x equals to 0, so that this term will get vanished. Okay, so put x equal to 0, this one will be as it is because it's a constant value, a into 0 plus 1, that is 1, and this term vanishes. Okay, because x equal to how much? 0. Okay, solving this, we'll get a equals to 1. Okay, yes. Now we want the value of b. To find b, we need to make this term as 0, then put x equals to how much? Minus 1, so that minus 1 and plus 1 will get cancelled. Okay, so put x equals to minus 1, this will be as it is, that is 1, this will become 0, plus b into minus 1. So here we'll get b equals to how much? Minus 1. Fine? Yes. So finally we can say like 1 upon x into x plus 1 equals to a upon x. A is what? 1. So 1 upon x plus what is b? Minus 1 upon x plus 1. That is 1 upon x minus 1 upon x plus 1 is the final answer for this example. Okay? Now coming to third example. Third example says 11 upon 3x minus 1 into 2x plus 3. Okay? So we can write this as a upon 3x minus 1 plus b upon, yes, that is 2x plus 3. Now take LCM. So a will be multiplied with this plus b will be multiplied with this in the numerator part, and denominator will be this into this. Fine. Now compare this with this. So denominator part will get cancelled. So we can say 11 equals to a into 2x plus 3 plus b into 3x minus 1. Okay. Now again here we want the value of a and b. Okay. To find a, we need to make this term as 0. Okay. For that, we will equate 3x minus 1 with 0. So 3x minus 1 equal to 0 will give us x equals to how much? 1 upon 3. Okay. So on putting x equals to 1 upon 3, this term will become 0. Okay. And then we can find the value of a. So put x equals to 1 upon 3. 11 is a constant value. So this will be as it is. A into 2x plus 3. That is 2 into x is how much? 1 upon 3. 2 into 1 upon 3 plus 3. Okay. 2 into 1 upon 3 plus 3. Now take LCM. 3. Okay. So 3 into 3, that is 9 plus 2, that is 11 upon 3. Now equate this with this. 11, 11 will get cancelled. So a into 1 upon 3 equals to 1. So a equals to, yes, how much? 3. Okay. In the same way, we want b value. Okay. Value of b. So we need to make this term as 0. To make this term as 0, we need to equate this with 0. That is 2x plus 3 should be equated to 0. In that, you will get x equals to how much? Minus 3 upon 2. Okay, you will get x equals to minus 3 upon 2. So put x equals to minus 3 upon 2, this term will get 0. Okay, then you can find easily that is value of b. Okay, yes. So 11 equals to, this term gets 0. Now b into 3 into, what is x? Minus 3 upon 2. So minus 3 into 3 upon 2, minus 1. Okay, yes. Take LCM. So this will become 2. So minus 9 minus 2, that is minus 11 upon 2. Now equate this with this. 11, 11 will get cancelled. So we will get b equals to how much? Minus 2. So here we get a equals to 3. And here we get b equals to minus 2. A equals to 3, b equals to minus 2. Put these values here. Okay, so you can say 11 upon 3x minus 1 into 2x plus 3 is equals to a, that is 3 upon 3x minus 1 minus, okay, what is b? Minus 2. So minus 2 upon 2x plus 3. And this is what? This is my final answer. Okay. Yes. Now coming to fourth example. Fine. Yes. Again, if you see fourth example, that is 2x minus 3 upon x minus 1 into x minus 2. Okay. Yes. Here again, we need to do the same job. Okay. Yes. That is a upon x minus 1 plus b upon x minus 2. Order is not important. Okay. You can write a upon x minus 2 plus b upon x minus 1. The end result, that is this, will remain always same. Okay, yes. So take x LCM, that is x minus 1 into x minus 2. A will be multiplied with x minus 2 plus b will be multiplied with x minus 1. Okay, now compare this to denominator part will get cancelled. You will be left with 2x minus 3, that is equals to a into x minus 2 plus b into x minus 1. Okay, yes. So put x equals to 1. Okay, why put x equals to 1? Because we want to find the value of a. Okay, for that this second term must be vanished. Okay, to vanish this second term, we need to put x equals to how much? 1. So that 1 minus 1 will become 0. Okay, yes. So put x equals to 1. So 2 in 2 minus 3, that is minus 1. In place of x, we need to put 1. So 2 into 1, that is 2 minus 1 minus 3, that is minus 1 equals to a into 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. Okay, this term will become 0. So you will get a equals to how much? 1. Fine. Yes. Similarly, we want to find the value of b. So we need to make this term 0. So for that, we need to put x equals to how much? 2. So that these two will get cancelled. So put x equals to 2. So 2 into 2, that is 4 minus 3, that is 1. 4 minus 3, that is 1 equals to, yes, this term will become 0 because we have to put x equals to 2. So 2 minus 2, that is 0. So this term will get 0. Here, b into 2 minus 1, b into 2 minus 1, that is 1. So solving this, you will get b equals to how much? 1. So a equals to 1, b equals to 1. So this is going to be 1 upon x minus 1 plus 1 upon x minus 2. Okay, now coming to the most important part of this type 1, that is fifth example. Fifth example says 2x square plus 5x minus 11 upon x square plus 2x minus 3. Yes, here we need to note one thing. Okay, always you need to remember one thing, that is the highest power of numerator must be lesser than, yes, must be less than highest power of x in the denominator. Okay, yes, but here I repeat that statement once again, the highest power of x in the numerator must be less than highest power of x in the denominator part. Okay, yes, in the, if that is the case, we can solve as we have solved in the previous four example. But here in this case we can see that is the highest power of x in the numerator is equals to highest power of x in the denominator part. Okay, so the way we are going to solve in this example is exactly the same way we will be solving if the highest power of x in the numerator is more than, okay, let's suppose the highest power of x in the numerator part is either greater or equals to the highest power of x in the denominator part, we need to solve in the same way. Okay, that is first we need to divide. Okay, yes, writing this here and writing this here. Okay, so you will see that is, okay, here we have x square plus 2x minus 3. Okay, and here we have, that is 2x square plus 5x minus 11. Fine, yes, here you can see we have x square and here we have 2x square. Okay, so we need to multiply this with 2 so that, yes, this will become 2x square. This is, that is 2x plus into 2, that is 4x minus 3 into 2, that is minus 6. Okay, yes, sign is same, so change the sign, that is minus here positive, then minus here negative, that is again positive, so these two will get cancelled. 5x minus 4x, that is x minus 11 plus 6, that is minus 5. Okay, so this is the quotient, this is the remainder. Okay, this is my quotient and this is my remainder. So we can rewrite this as this 2 here plus this remainder upon this part, that is x square plus 2x minus 3. Okay, now we are going to solve this as the same way we have solved in the previous four examples. Okay, yes, first we will try to make the factors of this, that is x square plus 2x minus 3. Okay, if you solve this part you will get the factors as x plus 3 into x minus 1. Okay, very simple part, you can solve it by yourself. Now solving this part, that is x minus 5 upon this, that is x plus 3 into x minus 1. So yes, we can rewrite this as a upon x plus 3 plus b upon x minus 1. Now take LCM, you will get x plus 3 into x minus 1, this into this plus this into this. Okay, now we will compare this with this. So we can say denominator part will get cancelled. So we can write x minus 5 equals to a into x minus 1 plus b into x plus 3. Okay, yes, here you can see. Now we want to find the value of a and b. Okay, so to find a, we need to make this term as 0. For that we need to put x equals to how much? Minus 3, so that this will get cancelled. So put x equals to minus 3. Here you will get minus 3 minus 4, that is minus 8. Here we have, yes, that is a into minus 3 minus 1, that is minus 4. On solving this, we will get a equals to how much? 2. Now we need to find b. For that this term must be 0. For that we will put x equals to how much? 1. Okay, so put x equals to 1. 1 minus 4, that is minus 4. Here this term will get cancelled. Here we need to put x equals to 1, that is b into 1 plus 3, that is 4. Solve this, you will get b equals to how much? Minus 1. So a equals to 2 and b equals to minus 1. Put these values over here, so you will get this part. Okay, that is x minus 5 upon x square plus 2x minus 3, that is this equals to a, that is 2 upon x plus 3, b, that is minus 1 upon x minus 1. Okay, so we have get this value, but in the question what it is asked, yes this. Okay, but this equals to what? 2 plus x minus 5 upon x square plus 2x minus 3. We have solved for this part, so we can rewrite this as, yes, here you can see. Okay, so this equals to 2 plus x minus 5 upon x square plus 2x minus 3. Okay, and this part, on solving this part you get these two terms. Okay, so we can write this here, that is 2 plus, yes, 2 upon x plus 3 minus 1 upon x minus 1, and this is what, this is my final answer. Okay, now let us start with the type number 2. Okay, yes.